Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today is going to be a really simple one. We're actually going to replace the fuel pump or lift pump on our 2003 Yamaha T60 outboard. We've already gone through the carburetors, gone through the rebuild kit, but we noticed almost immediately when we took it apart that this one was damaged. Now, what I'm going to do is actually just replace it as an assembly. Now, they do make the individual pieces on the inside if you wanted to rebuild yours, but honestly, by the time you add all those up, you're pretty much at the price of a brand new unit. So, really simple to do, just some basic hand tools are required. Let me gather those up and we'll get this thing swapped out. Now, we're replacing ours because it was damaged before I even started working on it. And as these things age, this plastic starts to get brittle, cracks, and then leaks. And that won't be a good thing. So we're just going to replace it as an assembly. Now you can order the individual pieces and build this up from scratch, but by the time you order the diaphragms and the different seals and this particular housing, you're already at the price of what Yamaha will sell the entire assembly for, and that's what I've decided to do. Now we are going to pull this one out and then I'm going to pull it apart so you can take a peek on the inside of it and make a decision as to whether or not you want to replace the entire thing like I am, or just replace some of the pieces on the inside. So at any rate, I would tell you, well, now we need to remove the hoses. Ours are already removed and or broken. So there's just a 2 10-millimeter bolts that we need to pull, and then it'll separate from the engine. At that point, we'll bring around the teardown bench, pull it down just to show you what's on the inside, and then we're gonna mount up our new assembly. Basically, the only thing you need to transfer over or replace would be this O-ring. Make sure there's no cracks and it's still pliable. Let's open up this one, take a peek. I can go ahead and tell you, this one doesn't even sound right. See how you can hear that one actually operating correctly? I kind of doubt this one, even if it weren't cracked, I seriously doubt it was working to begin with. That's how you know, right there. See how it holds it in? Release it. That one is not doing that. It's leaking. Let's open it up just for fun and see what was going on in there. Now, if you do decide to open yours up and replace the individual parts, if you would reference our exploded parts diagrams, that'll help you keep it organized and get it back together correctly, as there's several layers in here. Yeah, this one wasn't looking very healthy at all. And if you are going to pull yours apart and clean it out, don't spray any contact or carburetor cleaner on these O-rings. It'll cause them to swell up, and then you'll never get them back in there. There we go. Now to remove the diaphragm, you'll turn it roughly 90 degrees to where you can get to the pin. Release some tension off of it. Scoot it out. Don't just release it, otherwise it's going to go flying. There you go. So if you were just going to rebuild yours on your own, I would have ended up having to buy the diaphragm, this housing, this diaphragm, and then that seal. And guess what? You're almost at the cost of the entire assembly. But that is how you take it apart at any rate. But we are just going to mount up a brand new one. Got my O-ring in place. You want to work this back and forth to bring it in evenly, because it's compressing that spring on the inside. Now, before we can put these on, we need to extract the broken bits that came off of our housing, because they're still crammed up inside of the fuel lines. If you're having to do this to yours, just make sure you get all the pieces out of there. Otherwise, you're gonna stop up your fuel system with a bunch of broken plastic. All right, see, we've got a little bit of a cut there. We should have enough length to remove this cut and then reattach it without having to replace the hose. I think we're going to be good there. Now we need to extract the input from the filter. I'd recommend inspecting these when you go to dewinterize your outboard, especially if it's this old, because this is pretty much an engine killer if these are leaking fuel inside the cowling. I think that's got it. I don't want to risk taking the other one off because it's probably going to break the filter. Now I think we've got it. Now the input, it has the spring-loaded clamp, but the other two are actually held in place by zip ties. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up this project. Told you it was going to be easy. Well, listen, if you need these parts or anything else for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.